There are those days where I'm like that classic romantic, you know, haan, pyaar hota hai, ek wo hoga aur ghode pe sawar aayega. I live with a single mother that has taught me, shown me and inspired me to recognize the absolute importance of your job.
Yeah, but what is the status? Are you dating him?
Then what are trolls? Who are they? Somebody that's going on your picture and saying you're looking so fat, but they're still spending 10 seconds on your photo only, no? So that's whatever, true. Just it's fine, it's really not a big deal.
So there are newcomers who make their debut. She became an overnight sensation and she's en route to becoming the next superstar heroine that we have in the industry. Welcoming Sara Ali Khan in conversation with Pink Villa. How have you been? This has been long, long pending.
It has I'm so been, happy. I stalk you and I see a lot of your interviews and like I'm like a little obsessed with Pink Villa, as is everybody that may or may not admit it. So I'm really happy to finally be here talking to you.
So you know, Sara, I want to ask you this because this is our first interview, so I have a lot of questions. When you make your debut, they always say that a star kid has it easy. But you always have double the pressure to amp up and match up to your lineage and the legacy.
Yes.
You have actually managed to do that. There are a few star kids who are incredibly talented and you've proved that with your first two films.
Thank you.
How does it make you feel now? And what was the kind of pressure you went through before your first film released?
See, I'll be honest with you. I think that anything in life is as much pressure as you take. You know, I love my job. Whatever it is, whether it's a photo shoot, whether it's a brand shoot, whether it's promotions, whether it's shooting, I love every day of my job, you know. So I've never really looked at it as pressure. I also realize and recognize that if I feel pressurized by the fact that, you know, I am Saif and Amrita's daughter, which is something that I'm immensely proud of, then I really won't be able to perform.
True.
You know, so taking that pressure is just not smart. Yes, maybe I do have an advantage, but what am I doing with that if I'm going to be sitting and getting pressurized, you know? I didn't choose to be born to Saif and Amrita, even though I'm very proud that I am. So I don't think it's anything to be, you know, pressurized by. And everybody has their own journeys. And I think our audiences are extremely smart now. And at the end of the day, you know, if you have it, you'll make it. And if you don't, you won't. I mean, I've worked with four actors, three of whom who've come from really not the film industry.
True.
And they've all made it. So, I mean, you know, I think that everybody has different starting points, but it's about how you grow.
You know, Sara, when you picked Love Aaj Kal, as an actor, what is that instinctively makes you say yes to a film? This is your father's film, so does it make it more special?
Of course it makes it more special, but see, Love Aaj Kal is kind of not really like a sequel. It's its own take. It's Love Aaj Kal, what love is today, which is not the same as what love was in 2009, which is the film that my father did. But firstly, I don't think that I chose it. I think it chose me. I mean, you don't choose Imtiaz Ali. He comes to you and then you're like, yes, because you've seen the heroines that he works with. So, I mean, you know, if he came to me with almost anything, I would say yes. But Love Aaj Kal is a film that I personally loved. I think that the way Deepika and my father both showcased, you know, love in that time. And the way that Imtiaz also showed how love was, you know, back then. It was really beautiful, you know, and I think being given the opportunity to showcase what love is today is something that's so interesting. I mean, you know, it's something that people talk about. It's something that, you know, we all go through in life. And I think that it's a real privilege to be able to firstly be an Imtiaz Ali heroine in a romance genre. And then something like Love Aaj Kal, I mean, it's great.
What does romance and love mean to you? Are you a classic old school person? Are you contemporary, modern? Do you believe in dating apps?
And listen, I'll be really honest with you, when, especially when I'm like shooting this film and now I've seen a few rushes, I can't decide if I'm a aaj wali ladki or kal wali ladki. I think one thing is for sure, that I'm a moody girl and I wake up and like I really don't know. So there are those days where I'm like that classic romantic, you know, haan, pyaar hota hai, ek wo hoga aur ghode pe sawar aayega. And then I'm like, arey yaar, whatever dude, just do your work, do your job, date your career, and that's all that should actually matter. So it really depends. And I give interviews also, you know, and I say anything because I have no filter. So I'll say something to you and then tomorrow I'll say something else to somebody else. But I think the answer to your question is that it's moody.
Yeah.
And with me also, love is also moody. So kabhi kabhi hai, kabhi kabhi nahi hai, mujhe khud nahi pata. It's all fun.
What do you look for in a man that you would love to be with? What are the few qualities that you would, you know, you would love him to have and not love him to have at all?
You know, this is an interesting question that you're asking me. And it kind of ties into my film very well. What I think is very, very important, especially in today's day and age, is understanding and mutual respect, you know. When you see the trailer, you'll see that there's a line that I say that, you know, mera career mere liye sabse zyada important hai, which resonates with me extremely strongly.
Absolutely.
I mean, I'm a very, very driven girl. I live with a single mother that has taught me, shown me and inspired me to recognize the absolute importance of your job.
Yeah.
You know, so I think that most importantly, I think it would be somebody that understands that, honors that and supports that. I'm quite independent, so I don't really need, you know, support, but somebody that doesn't pull me away from that is, I think, what it takes.
Your and you know, the best thing about you is that you are yourself. There is, there's no fakeness. Like
no,
you said, there's no filter, which is the best thing, right?
There is.
There's always this pressure to look and behave and talk a certain way. You have gone on record saying who you want to date, who you have loved all your life, who you have had a crush on. Do you think that put a lot more focus on that? Like, a lot of people have asked you about whether you're dating Kartik because you're doing a film with it.
Right.
But do you think that put a lot of, and are you okay with it? Like,
listen,
is the status also?
I'll be honest with you, I'm okay with it because people will get used to me. The fact that I have no filter, I mean, this might be the first time I've said something like that, but it won't be the last.
Exactly.
You know, I'll say things that come to my mind because that's just the kind of person I am, you know. And I think that it's important somewhere down the line to not have a filter, because like the other day I went somewhere and I had oil in my hair, you know, because I think pressure is exactly as much as you take. And to be very honest with you, maybe if I knew how to be fake, or I knew how to consistently have this filter or different public persona and private personality, you know, maybe I would wing it, but I really don't.
Which is,
you know,
very good.
I think that our job is so taxing itself in a good way. We like it, so we don't feel it. But every day that you're on different sets, you're being different people. And I think you should channelize your creative energies there, as opposed to pretending to be somebody else somewhere else, you know. So, but the one thing that I do recognize is the fact that my lack of filter can be perceived as like a bit, what is she saying sometimes? But I think people will get used
to me,
you know. Aaj maine kuch bol diya, kal main kuch aur bol dungi.
You're not acting in real life.
But you shouldn't. Yeah. You really, really shouldn't. So.
But what is the status? Are you dating him?
I'm dating him in the film, and that's what matters. So please come and watch us dating for like 2.5 hours on the 14th of February on Valentine's Day.
In real life, you're not. Tell me something. You have so many films lined up. There's Coolie number one.
Yes, there is.
Do you somehow feel that, you know, you have finally found your footing in the industry? When you're debuting, you are still a little nervous and a little wary of how things are going to pan out for you. But today, I have to tell you that you have been one of the most, if not the most, promising faces that we have in this generation. I'm proud to call somebody like you coming from our generation, because I feel that youngsters like you make people our age feel really proud. You know, I've said this to Ali, I'm saying this to you, because it is because of you guys that we feel proud. How do you take the change and the perception that has happened with you right now?
See, you know, I don't really think about it that much. I think that the main thing that I like about my job is the fact that it allows versatility, you know. I go through a riot of emotions on set that I wouldn't necessarily go through all the time, you know. For instance, shooting with Imtiaz sir, he's the kind of director that every day on sets takes you to feel exactly what that character is feeling at that point of time. And that's like a huge riot of emotions that I haven't necessarily gone through in my own personal life. Talking about David sir, I mean, his set is like a, you know, candy shop meets fantasy land meets, like, you know, I don't even know, like just a volcano of energy with Varun Dhawan. So you don't really know what's happening. But I think that, like, what I really like about my job is that I go through a lot of different things, and there's a lot of versatility.
Yeah.
So I don't even look at it as strategy or balance or, you know, what kind of films do you want to do. I just want to be able to have fun and be convinced about everything that I'm doing.
But you know, you're working with all the maverick filmmakers that we have all grown up watching, maybe, you know.
Yeah.
How does it make you feel? Being a newcomer and working with those heavyweight,
you know,
heavyweight
I'll tell
people.
You that, like I said, that when you're choosing a film, I don't really think about too much strategy and this, that and the other. I just want to do films that I'm convinced about and films that are versatile and diverse, you know. But the one thing that I've always prayed for and asked for is a good filmmaker. You know, I think it's just so important, because that's what films are. They are a director's medium. You are portraying a director's vision. And I think being part of people with different visions is just really the reason that I do what I do. You know, Aanand sir is also somebody that I really, really admire. Whether it's Tanu Returns, Ranjana, I think that he tells stories so beautifully. And, you know, while all his actors have been amazing, and you know, Akshay and Dhanush are amazing.
Yeah.
I must say that the way that he tells stories about women and the way that he portrays women is just something that I so love.
Yes.
So absolutely. I'm really, really happy to be able to be a part of a film like that. And even Imtiaz Sir, for that matter. I mean, look at his actors. Yeah. I mean, he's worked
very
with like Alia, Kareena, Deepika.
Anushka.
I mean, Anushka. To even, it's always been on my wish list to be able to work with Imtiaz. I cannot believe that in a month's time, it's going to be part of my filmography. It almost feels amazing. And in the middle of all this, there is Rohit Sir and David Sir and Gaana and drama and, you know, there was Gattu Sir, Abhishek Sir, yeah. you know, who did this like lovely romantic film. And I just think that I've just been so lucky and so privileged to have had such different films with such sure filmmakers, yeah. you know, and sure about their world, yet different from one another's. And what else can you ask
distinct
for?
Distinct vision also.
Exactly.
Is there a plan to put as many films in place? Like in a year?
No, I don't think it's about quantity at all. I think it's about quality, most importantly. It's about seeing which films come yeah. to you, firstly, more than anything
else. There are
else.
So many films that have come to you and Saif together.
No, I don't know about any of that. I don't know about any of that.
But when are we going to see both of you together?
When there's the script that demands it, I think that this is something so important. Like for instance, whether it's Sushant or Ranveer or Kartik or Varun, I really hope that I work with all of them again and again. But I can't like work with my father again and again, you know.
Yeah.
That'll have to be something really, really special.
Yeah.
So I think when that happens, you know, I'm really excited to hopefully do that. And when the right script finds us, I'm sure it'll be great fun to do that.
Finally, I'll ask you this because this has been like my question. You know, we genuinely adore you for the way you are. Mm. There are times that it can get taxing.
Yeah.
Where everybody goes through trolls and yeah. you know all this.
I don't take this troll thing very seriously though.
How do you deal with it? Has it ever affected you in any
Never. Never. Touch wood, it really never has. And I think that the reason for that has to be, firstly, like I have a great team.
Yeah.
You know. I have a superb mother,
yeah.
I have a superb father, I have friends and family that keep me grounded, keep me real.
And a superb grandmother.
And a superb
I'll tell you what she said on Kareena's show.
Yeah.
She actually went on to say that she's extremely proud of the way you handle yourself on and off screen, which is a great thing to say.
It really is. And even my grandmother, for instance, you know, I think that all of us have been raised in a very kind of balanced way.
Yes.
You know, as much as I love my job, as much as I enjoy waking up every day and going to work, I recognize that it is a job.
Yes.
I recognize that after I finish this interview with you today, that I'm fully enjoying and I'm fully a part of, and I'm enjoying this whole team in here and this light and this camera and you and me and having this conversation. It's great. But the second this is over, I'm going to get into my car and take my mascara off and take my heels off and wear my white salwar kameez and go hang with my friends and talk about random things. And the fact that I can do that and the fact that I know that that is also my life as much as this is what I think keeps the balance. And what are trolls? Who are they? Somebody that's going on your picture and saying you're looking so fat, but they're still spending 10 seconds on your photo only, no? So
that's
whatever,
true.
Just it's fine. It's really not a big deal. And you know, I don't take it seriously.
Just stay the way you are because you're every bit amazing.
Thank you.
And we love you.
Thank you.
And all the best for Love Aaj Kal.
On the 14th of February, not two.
It's
not
Love Aaj Kal.
It's Love Aaj Kal.
Okay.
Okay. But it's releasing on Valentine's Day. There is no better way to spend Valentine's Day other than caramel popcorn and Love Aaj Kal.
Thank you for this lovely
thank
conversation
you.
And thank you for joining us.
Thank you very
us.
Much. Thank you. Hello and Namaste, I'm Sara Ali Khan and you are watching me on Pink Villa. Please, please, please do like, share and subscribe.